and welcome to this special segment of Oprah. Today, we will be interviewing a variety of people before the French Revolution. Now put your hands together and give the noble Aldric a warm welcome. Bonjour, Aldric.
Bonjour, Oprah.
So, Aldric, where do you live?
I live on the French countryside, and I own about 100 acres of land. I tax my peasants about half of their earnings, which I believe is a very reasonable price.
So, life must be good.
Very.
I believe you hold a prestigious place in government. Tell me a little bit about it.
I enjoy my place in government. Me and the other high-ranked nobles commonly meet with the king. I have a large say in politics. Government keeps my life pretty satisfying.
What do you think of all the peasant outcries over the nation?
I think the peasants need to suck it up and pull their shit together. I have to do almost all the work with owning all this land and collecting these taxes and working in politics. The least they can do is just pay their damn taxes.
Okay, we're gonna take a quick commercial break now while we try to calm him down. Bye. And we're back, live with Oprah. Now that Aldric has had his food and drink and has been calmed down, we can now continue the show. So, Aldric, how do you feel about the three-estate society, and will you fight in government to protect it?
I don't care what the peasants say about it, but the estates keep society well-organized, and it keeps me and other nobles and the clergy happy. And yes, I'll fight to the death to defend it, because it keeps me rich. If we go to court, I'll surely be there.
Interesting. You seem to feel strongly about your cause. Well, moving on. Lastly, do you feel sympathetic towards workers and peasants?
Hell no. They're lucky to even be allowed to live on my land. Like I said before, I do way more work than them, and I have much more responsibility.
Well, Aldric, thanks for being on our show, and wonderful answers. So, nice meeting you. Our next guest is the infamous philosophical writer, Patrice. So Patrice, tell me a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm a member of France's bourgeoisie middle class. I live in Paris, and I write for a living. My books are pretty popular with the lower class, because they talk about equality and values of being a human being, so I have to say that I make a good living.
But your life isn't all picture perfect, is it, Patrice?
Well, unfortunately, no. I mean, taxes are so high right now because of all of France's economic problems. Plus, bread prices in Paris are through the roof! Sorry, okay? Anyways, I can barely afford to keep my family alive. I mean, my life is better off than some, but it could be a lot better.
Ooh, that sounds harsh considering all the work you do. But still, peasants do even more work than you, and they barely even get paid. What do you think of that?
Well, I'm glad I'm not a peasant, but I have to say, France's society is so unequal right now. I mean, everyone should be taxed equally, not just the lower class.
Well, it's too bad you feel that way, Patrice. But on a lighter note, I hear you've written many great works.
Well, I've written 10 books about human nature and the morals of society. My greatest and most popular work is called In Absence of Equality. Can I have a look at it?
Sure. So Patrice, do your works reflect anything on society and which class you side with?
Well, that book you're looking at right there talks about the differences between the three estates. I talk about how the first two make up less than 2% of the population, but they still own more than 20% of all the land in France. That's pretty sad, huh?
Congratulations on the works, Patrice. Now tell me, what other Enlightenment writers do you agree with, and have you borrowed any of their ideas?
Well, Oprah, I have to say I was greatly influenced by Voltaire and Rousseau's ideas of freedom and equality. I often quote their works.
Finally, Patrice, how do you think the growing feud between nobles and peasants will turn out?
Well, the peasants are at the end of their ropes right now, and they greatly outnumber the nobles. I can say one thing, this is going to turn out into an all-out war pretty fast. I can't wait to see the nobles get their ass's kid.
Well, Patrice, I'm glad you feel that way, because after all this interviewing, I think I feel that way too. But don't tell Audric, he had a mighty big sword with him. So anyways, Patrice, glad to have you on the show.
Thanks, Oprah.
Yep.
Good to see you.
See you later.
See ya.
Welcome back to the special French Revolution edition of Oprah. Next, we will be having the French servant, Enzo. So please give a warm welcome for Enzo. Hello, Enzo. Please have a seat. Ooh, nice clothes, Enzo. I must ask, why are you so formally dressed for a servant?
Well, you know, my master says that I have to look formal to represent him. Also, I have to run around to complete my errands, so I carry these. Plus, I wear these aprons so I can clean and cook for him.
So, Enzo, how do you like your new life in the city?
I like my new life in Paris a lot. I have good food and comfy blankets and fluffy pink pillows. Also, my clothes are the latest in servant fashion.
So, Enzo, fluffy pink pillows. Weirdo! Okay, so anyways, why did you even move to the city in the first place?
Well, Oprah, my life in the farm is horrible. I worked all day and saw very little. I had paint all over and barely ate anything. So I saw many moving to the city and was like, well, why not? It can't be any worse.
That sounds hardy, but... So moving on, Enzo, what about the girls? Got any chicks you dig?
Oh, there's the girls. Well, you see, my master forbid me to have any relationships at all. I was even going to propose to this one girl. She was probably off with some other jack.
Bless me, Enzo. How do you feel about your master?
Oh, I hate my master. He's treating like shit on the street. And he always talks to me as if I'm a monkey. I quit, I'm joining the rebellion.
Oh, I guess that wraps that up. But anyways, tomorrow we'll be heading out to visit a farmer on his noble's estate. And yeah, so we'll be having a commercial break and I need to go, me and the crew need to go check if Enzo has killed anyone. Hello. Today we will be meeting with the French peasant, Pius. Hello, Pius.
Oh, Oprah, nice hairdo.
Oh, thank you. I got it at the Sheep Cuts Hair Salon for 1,000,000 francs.
And I must say, your full body makeover is pretty nice.
Thank you, Pius. So, Pius, I heard you just moved to the countryside. Tell me, how is your new farm doing and what does your new house look like?
My new farm, he's doing terribly. I'm taxed for more than he earns. My house is made of poop and mud and wood. In fact, my two beloved children became sick and died because of it.
Oh yes, and I'm so sorry about the little ones, Pius. Tell me, how did they die again?
Well, because of how much the king taxes us lowly peasants, I have no money to buy food and clothing for my family. Also, as is true with many peasant families, we have to keep many animals indoors with our food and clothing because we don't have room for them outside.
So moving on, I heard taxation is running steep nowadays. So tell me, how is it affecting you and your family?
Well, Oprah, it's true. Taxing is really ruining things lately. I can barely afford to keep my property and my wife, she's as hungry as I am.
So Pius, how do you feel about government, and how much do you despise those above you?
I
those government officials and those f***ing nobles.
So Pius, how's the old wife doing?
Oh, the wife, he's doing excellent.
Do you see her a lot?
See, that is the problem. We don't work together. So we see each other very little. And at night we are so worn out, there is no time for the fun. Actually, I'm surprised we had the first two children. This is my wife, Bertha.
Hello, viewers. Well, as you can see, I got tired of my makeover and I decided to go back to my original body. So, anyways, thanks for watching Oprah, and we'll see you on our next show.
Oh my god!
Go down there. Go sit
Wait,
there.
What's wrong with it?
All the lens covers on. Go over there and I'm gonna do a close up on your face and you're gonna say our next guest is a.
Sorry, are you just gonna cut out this beginning?
Yeah, that's this.
I have good food and comfy bed. Fucking big doors.
Hey, you're on!
Look, oh. Shoot water.
What?
We gotta start again. Oh. The girls. Well, you see.
No!
What?
You're supposed to go like this.
Oh, I ate my master.
I don't care what the peasant right? I don't care what the peasants say about it, but the estates keep society.
You seem to. Oh, shoot. Is it on me
Wait,
only right now?
Yeah, it's on you
say,
only.
Do you want me to say live or do you want me to say work? Because I said work that time.
Do you like that?